Do you want a tool that helps you understand DNA relationships? Well, stay tuned. I've got one for you today. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, where we help you understand your DNA, climb your family tree, and write your ancestor story along the way. Today, I'm going to show you how to use a tool called the Relationship Estimator. This can be used with DNA data to give you an idea of what relationships somebody might be. Now, you can find this tool on the dnaadoption.org website. I've got a link in the description below. Let me show you what you need to download. On the Relationship Estimator app, you have the zip file that you're going to download. Now, I'll cover the cluster relationship in another video. Right now, we're just going to use the Relationship Estimator. You're going to download that file to your computer. You need to have a Windows computer in order to use this. You just extract that file into a folder, and then you're going to go to the application, and I'll show you that application. This is the Relationship Estimator app, and it looks really simple, and it really is. There's some fields that you can enter in information about the DNA with the match, and then when you process that, it's going to tell you what those estimated relationships are. So let me show you a quick example here. Now, this is between a match that I know the relationships. Let me enter in some information. I have 16, I have 8.8, I have 23.4, I have 13.3, I have 20.7, and I have 17.5. What this is this is the segments of DNA that match between these two people. And all I've done is use the forward slash to divide that out. You can use any segments all the way down to 5 centimorgans. Now, if you're going below that, then the calculator is not going to be as accurate. Next, I want to tell what the source of this information is, whether it is from Ancestry or whether it is from 23andMe, Family Tree DNA, or GEDmatch. So this information was from GEDmatch, so I'm going to click that one, and then I can process it. And you can see that it automatically calculates everything in this area right here. It tells me that it's 99.7 centimorgans total, which is just adding up all of those numbers. It's telling me that the longest segment is 23.4, which I can see, that there's 6 segments, and the percent of shared DNA. The next section over here is the estimated relationships, and it shows me 4 relationships that this could be. A second cousin 1 time removed, a third cousin, a half first cousin 1 time removed, and a second cousin 2 times removed. Now, I happen to know that this is actually a second cousin 2 times removed with this match. And you might be wondering, what are all these little numbers right here? There's 11111, 11110, 11100, 01110. Well, this is a way of categorizing how likely that match is. What the Relationship Estimator is looking at is it's looking at the total centimorgan range. It's looking at the largest segment centimorgan range. It's looking at the number of segments in that range, the percent of DNA shared range, and the closest to average of shared DNA. And this is from data that has been gathered from lots of different matches. And so each one of these ones or zeros correspond with that. So the very first one means that it is within the total centimorgan range. The second one means that it is in with the largest segment centimorgan range, and on and on. Now the last one, the fifth one, is the closest to average of your shared DNA. And this is basically the tiebreaker for this. So coming back to this match, we can see that this first one has a 1 in each one of those categories. Now the first one corresponds to the total CM range, the second one corresponds to the largest segment CM range, and on. The last one is different because only one of these relationships will have this last one as a 1. You'll notice that all the others, that last digit is a 0. It's not a 1. That's because this column is really the tiebreaker to determine which of these relationships is the most probable. We can see from this that the calculation has come up with the second cousin 1 times removed as the most probable. However, I know for a fact that this is a second cousin 2 times removed. You're going to see a lot of this when you're dealing with relationships, particularly the further away those relationships are. And that's just because there's so much overlap between each one of these different groups of relationships. Now what I can do is I can label this. So I'm going to put the initials of these two matches in here, and then I can put the known relationship if I know that. And in this case, I know that this is a second cousin two times removed. I click on the save button, and that is going to save that match. You'll notice everything just disappeared. That's okay, because I can show you another way that you can enter this same data. Now, if you remember, I said that there was 99.7 centimorgans here. So I'm not going to use this first one up here. I'm going to now use these ones and put in the information that I know. So it's 99.7 centimorgans. I know that the largest is 23.4, and I know that there are 6 centimorgans. And for this, I'm going to say that my source is ancestry. Even though it's not ancestry, I'm just going to say that. You'll notice then that when I click process, there's a couple of different things. One, it automatically calculated the percent shared right here. That's 1.35%. That's the same as the other. But the other thing that it did is it came over here and it gave me some extra relationships. So if you remember, I had only 4 possible relationships based on the data that I inputted originally from GEDmatch. Well, if this same data I say is from Ancestry, because of how Ancestry reports data, there's a little bit difference in the relationship possibilities. Also, there's only 4 places, there's not 5 places. And that last one is going to be the tiebreaker again. But in this case, I can see that, hey, there's this fourth cousin that is a outside possibility if it's the data is from Ancestry, as well as a third cousin one time removed, again, outside of Ancestry. Now, I don't need this because this is not from Ancestry, so I'm not going to save this. But if I wanted to go back and find my results, remember, I already labeled them. And so I can just put this in here. Let's say that I remember that one of these was from JY. Well, I want to now find those relationships. Now, when I click on the find, it's going to come up with all the different, with the very first one that I put in. But I can use this drop-down box here to find any of the ones. And so I'm going to go and I'm going to select for PS, the one that I just did. And you can see there's those 4 relationships. But I can also go and look at some of these others that are second cousin once removed with this same JY person. So this is a nice way that you can organize some of your data and actually take a look at how those different relationships match up. If I want to, I can use the delete key and I can delete one of these relationships, or I can clear them all out. Now the report button here is if you want to report a relationship that is known yet is not falling within this. Like for instance, if this did not show a second cousin one time removed, but I knew for certain that it was a second cousin one time removed, well then I could click on the report and that's going to send an email to the developers with that information. So they're going to be able to add that to the overall algorithm of how this is calculating. Now some of you may be wondering, well, why would I use this if there's other tools out there that actually do this? For instance, this is doing something similar to what Watto is doing. It's doing something similar to the shared centimorgan tool that is also on DNA Painter, as well as some other tools that you may find on the web. Well, the major advantage to having the relationship estimator is this resides on your computer. And so you don't need to have access to the internet to use it. And you may have this data that you've downloaded to a spreadsheet from matches that you're looking at when you're sitting at the beach or something like that. The relationship estimator does not rely on an internet connection. And so that's the major value of this. So if you haven't downloaded the relationship estimator and you want to try it out, then check the link in the description below. If you have any questions about how to use the relationship estimator, then put it in the comments and I'll try to answer it for you. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel.